Thank you for watching, liking, commenting, sharing, and subscribing right now.
Guess what I got, Diana? Flowerlicious. It's kind of convenient to have an elevator right next to your room. Gotta be careful turning the camera around in an elevator when I don't know that someone might be in here. That would be a little awkward. I could pretend that I'm fiddling with the settings or... We were stopped on 4 and nobody got on. Seems like I was doing this yesterday. Standing out here waiting, this time not for a shuttle. I'm going to be picked up by my cousin Pete and his wife Denise. You haven't met them yet. They happen to be on my father's side. I don't know if they're going to want to be on the vlog though, and Diana is not feeling well again. It seems to happen in the morning for some reason or another. Hopefully she'll start feeling better throughout the day, but it may just be me flying solo. My espresso looks like it's in a flower pot, but it's very, very, very good. And you don't need much of it to fill you up, because you don't want to be filled up with too much caffeine in Austin, Texas. Bad things might happen. And my flower pot is sitting atop a very carpeted table and chairs. All sorts of fun stores that are not normal. That's what the car said. Austin's kind of a... odd man out, isn't it, as far as Texas is concerned?
Yeah, it's...
You guys got a zebra that's dressed up like Carmen Lucy in disguise with diamonds? Am I through the looking glass here, people? It is crazy here. This is a hotel. It's not even the... event that's across the street. Nice curtains that go all the way up. Jeez, crackers. I'm waiting to make a connection with a business liaison. I haven't really seen anybody that I recognize in the room yet. I haven't met this person either. I mean, I'm saying I know who I'm meeting with and she knows what I look like, but I'm saying I don't recognize anybody else that I know who's currently in the room. That was a fantastic meeting. I think I set up a few new partnerships for Vlogger Fair too. I've had too many beers. Do you guys know this guy, Tim Street? Are you familiar with any of his work? French Maid TV? Tim, say hello to my audience.
Hey audience, how's it going?
Actually, they're not an audience, it's a community.
Hey community, how are you?
So Tim, what are you up to?
You know, I've been doing all kinds of crazy, wacky stuff. Thinking about doing some more French Maid, but been playing around in creepy video stuff. I just put out an ebook. If you have an iPad, it's only available on the iPad. It's called Vids, V-I-D-S. Story about a woman, a jilted woman, who gets back at her married lover by building a website where she stalked him, hid cameras, caught him with other women. You can download a free sample at the iBook store.
Not based on a true story?
No, but you might think it once you watch the videos.
Great. Thanks, Tim.
There you go.
Tim and I were sharing a few beers together. Well, I mean, we were drinking our own beers. I wasn't, like, drinking out of his glass or he drinking out of my glass, but good guy to know. He's been in the video industry for ages. I've got a chauffeur. I'm showing you what he's fur driving. That's what he's doing. It's what your fur. Better than an aquifer to keep you from being thirsty. That's what an aquifer. I'm not really that humorous right now. Unlike a bone, that's usually always humorous depending on which bone you're talking about.
Traffic is insane out here.
Yeah, I'd say.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, we've been behind this car for a block. At least, well, I only got in, admittedly, like a block ago. Now we're off to a gaming expo, which is not an official part of South by Southwest.
Oh, that's awesome.
Or is it? Do you know?
It kind of is. It just happens to be a free-for-all, so you don't need a badge to get in.
That car's got a mustache. You know, I almost want to take this sign back to Seattle, because it's got a different meaning up there now. And Colorado, too.
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of stinky. You know, I've never touched a Wii U. Ever.
What?
Do I look like David DeFranco to you? It just looks a little awkward when it has the player controls floating on the side.
So the whole concept behind this is, as newer technology comes out, rather than buying an entirely new computer, you just buy the board. And that's how it works. It's all solid state, so the only moving part's the fan. The higher end model, which is the 7A, starts at $999, gives you 128 gigs of storage, 8 gigs of RAM DDR3.
What's the video card? Video processor?
Yeah, you're gonna get the AMD quad core. It's the Radeon 7000 series, so it's an APU.
Cool.
One of the first things that we did.
It's interesting to see like which booths are getting traffic and which ones aren't. I mean, I don't think it would be a surprise which ones are getting more traffic than others. The ones with games are getting more traffic. The ones without games, not so much. What's interesting about the pool table is the graphics you see on the table are actually being generated from Kinects and cameras above. How's that for a game controller? There's a Brony Fair. I found someone who uses Google Plus. Community, meet Aaron Wood. Aaron Wood, meet my community.
Hello, community. I do social media and pop culture propaganda. Stuff like video games, food, social media.
Which one?
It's in the color.
I actually have a Spiro at home. I haven't played with it in a while. Makes me want to play with it. I mean, the Spiro. I like games, it's just I'm not a gamer. Anytime I say that I like games and say the games that I like, people don't necessarily agree with me because I play casual games. And I realize that's not very cool.
It counts. It does.
Yeah, but the real gamers would never say that it counts. I mean, I could broadcast me playing, you know, those classic games that I used to love to play.
Oh, that's cool. They got their own club.
Do you know where you're at?
No.
Isn't this your town?
I don't claim it.
Okay. Downtown Austin. Yeah, new construction everywhere you look, seemingly. Like right over here. Like new construction right there.
Yeah, they keep tearing down a bunch of our old buildings, some of them cherished.
If I had to live in a city, it would probably be Austin. I mean, in Texas. I had to. Like, you had me at gunpoint, which I believe, isn't that like the state bird here is the gun?
Yeah, yeah, and I wouldn't joke about
it. It's Luigi. You've taken me to the best bakery in Austin, Texas.
It's the best bakery probably in this part of Texas, at least.
No, you're supposed to say in the world.
Oh, yeah. It's the best bakery in the world, by far.
We'll see.
Most delicious show on earth.
That's its name?
Yes.
Oh.
It's called Sugar Circus.
Oh! A clown's not gonna serve it to me, right?
No.
Okay, good. They kinda creep me out. They castrate cakes here. I picked out 6 tasty treats for Diana, including a peanut butter, red velvet. No, that's not red velvet. It's something that's not red velvet. A creamsicle, cookie dough, German chocolate, and chocolate. Now, the only question I have is, what the hell did I get with this one? What was that one?
Mexican hot.
Oh, yeah, Mexican hot cocoa, which is, by the way, her nickname. What's that building with the pointy glass things?
That's the Frost Bank.
It looks like frost.
It looks like an owl from the side.
It's warm and cozy.
No, it's not. I'm going to start sweating.
Well, then take off your sweater.
hoodie. Thanks again for liking and sharing all our videos.